Hello everyone. The purpose of this tutorial is to explain the method to replace the mesh files with the new files in the Fluent. So for example, here I run the case, and after solution I want to change the geometry of the in this particular case the fins, and there heat transfer from the solid body which is on the bottom, and then through fins the heat is transferred to the fluid. And the air is coming from left side, and it will convert the heat energy from these fins to the atmospheric air. And I have modeled the two type of the fins here. One is simple cylindrical fins, and the second case is the fins with the same fins with the spheres on the surfaces. So these hemispheres are at the 120 degrees apart from each other, angular position, and there are three series of hemispheres on the each fin. And right now I have just solved the case without these spheres, and also I have the corresponding solid file, that is where the heat will transfer from bottom side where the heat flux is applied, and then it will conduct through these fins, and after conduction through convection the heat will be carried away from these fins to the outside. And similarly I have the solid parts also for the fins with the hemisphere, and in this case I have solved the first case where I have the solid body and the fluid body with the simple fins, and now I want to replace these files with the second file which has the hemisphere, and for that I will go to replace zones, and I want to replace first the fluid part and then I will replace the solid part. So I will first browse my mesh file, and this mesh file is a design2fluid.msh. click on OK. So we have this new file, and I want to replace the fluid with a new file created material 16, and just click on the replace. And if you want to interpolate data from the previous case to the new case, you can also take this option here and then click on replace, and it will take some time because the mesh is around 2 million nodes, and in terms of cells it's around 10 million, so it will take some time. And it is working on the mesh reading, and right now it's reading the design 2 fluid. Design 1 is the geometry without the hemispheres on the fins, and design 2 is the fins, the cylindrical fins with the hemisphere. In fact, the number of nodes are the 5 million and the number of cells are around 17 million. And now it is reading the mesh file and changing the names from the old names to the new names. And again, it will take some time. And right now it is copying the boundary conditions from the old mesh to the new mesh. And also it is interpolating data from the previous mesh file, case file, to the new mesh file. So we have successfully change the mesh from the without the hemisphere to the new mesh. And now I will display the mesh. We have the fins. And now you can check that we have the fins with the hemisphere on the surface. And also we can display the bottom side of the geometry in this way. And second mesh file is a mesh file for the solid body which is inside the fins here and inside the fins. Again I will browse the new mesh file for the design 2 solid. Click on OK. And right now it's reading the mesh file and just select these two files. This is the old file, this is the new file. Select them and then click on replace. And in a similar way, the solid body inside the fin will also be replaced. This is true for the any mesh replacement in any case. It's not only valid for this case, but you can do it any with any case. So the benefit of this method is that you can retain the data files, you can retain the boundary conditions, you can retain the other settings all in the this existing file, and you just replace the your mesh file. And in this way, we have just replaced the two mesh files. One is for solid body, one is for fluid body. And these are from the simple fins to the fins with the hemisphere on them. And in the wireframe or in the edges format, you can see the mesh file from inside the solid body and also inside the fluid body. So this is a procedure to replace the mesh file without creating the new case file from the scratch.